Hello everyone and welcome to another time lapse. Now this video is going to be a little bit different from the ones that I've posted before, but with the new Smash game blindsiding us all with a release date that's right around the corner, and with everyone on YouTube talking about their hopes and dreams for their new roster, I figured I'd put my hat in the ring yet again. Now, since I've already done a Smashified Daisy, and there's not really a lot to go off of from the teaser trailer that they gave us, I figured it'd be fun this time to actually discuss Daisy's addition to Smash from an art and design perspective. So instead of being a fanboy and talking about why I think she should be in the game, we're going to be talking about Daisy as if she was in the game. Like, what would she look like and how would she play? How would she be presented to us is the main thing that we're going to be talking about today. Now, I'm not a game designer, but my background is in animation for film, illustration, and concept design, and while I've never gotten a chance to use this professionally, I also have a degree in marketing and branding, which I think is going to be a pretty good help with designing the Flower Princess for Smash Bros. There are a few key points that I'd like to make during this discussion. Her character design and her animations, which will kind of bleed into talking about her moveset, however, we'll be focusing more on how she moves rather than what she does. Now when it comes to her design, I've already created one in anticipation for the previous Smash Bros., and I still stand by it, though I would change a few things to separate her from her counterpart a tiny bit, and more represent Sarasa Land, and more so the Chai Kingdom in her design. So many people believe that Daisy would be wearing her sports gear and be centered around all of the Mario sports titles, but to me that feels like the easy way out. Yes, it will make her very different from Peach, but she has so much more to draw from. Princess Daisy isn't a sports fanatic or a health guru, she's a princess. A tomboyish and very obnoxious princess, but she's still a princess nonetheless. Now, I'm not going to say that she shouldn't have her sporty outfit for Smash, but I think that befitting her royal standing, her dress should be what she is wearing by default. As I said, I would keep what I designed for her for Smash 4, albeit with a couple of minor tweaks here and there, to capture more Sarasa Land and the Chai Kingdom where she resides. So, starting from the head down, there's a couple of things that I would start changing. First and foremost, her crown. So, I did a lot of research in the original Smashified design that I made for her. I took a lot of reference from the places where the different kingdoms in Sarasa Land are referencing. that's a long sentence. So basically her crown was sort of embossed with characters from Easter Island, and it's too much. It's too much, so I decided to take that out. I think that they can probably embroider her crown a little bit in the new Smash, but I think just having it nice and plain and everything would probably be best. I also ended up giving her a V-neck, going very English with her dress design, since Princess Peach was given a very updated and regal look to her princess dress. I figured I'd try to do the same without just copying Peach, but now that I look at it again, the V-neck just doesn't suit her, and like I said, I like the idea that Princess Daisy resides in Chai Kingdom of the Sarasa Land, and so to represent that, I decided to give her more like a Chinese dress kind of feel to at least the top half of her dress. Everything else is pretty much the same. I left the big poofs at the bottom of her dress and all of the embroidery design at the bottom. I did add some like frill, almost like petals, like flower petals, at the bottom of the dress to kind of set it apart and kind of break up the yellow and orange a little bit more, and I think it worked out pretty well.